Alright, what's up everybody? It's your dude Mike Green, Huxley Harlem. We're back in the beautiful with a sexy, beautiful young lady. Miss Ndami. Did I get it right?
That's right.
Okay, alright. And she's here on the Huxley Harlem Show, so welcome to the Huxley Harlem Show.
Thanks for having
How
me.
How you doing, beautiful?
I'm good, and yourself?
What's going on in your life?
Everything's going on.
Yeah.
I'm out here with this album, you know, just promoting before it comes out. It comes out.
The Pink Elephant.
The Pink Elephant album.
Talk to us a little bit about the concept of the title and who'd you work with on
okay.
the album?
Well, the album's title is Pink Elephant, and it's a take on the saying, there's an elephant in the room.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, it's a concept that extends more. Why is it a pink elephant? It extends more to a message for women about empowerment and upliftment and understanding the importance of having the quiet fire and having the brilliance of that light and allowing it to shine despite obstacles. And sometimes people don't allow that opportunity and they don't get the chance to be their brightest and their best. So it's important for us to feel empowered to shine.
Women.
But okay. That message extends to all people, period.
Oh, okay. I feel you. I dig it.
But you know, women, because that I am a woman, yeah. I relate to that. But it's a bigger thing.
Yeah.
Because I think everyone at some point in time.
I see you got the pants and look on and everything. You looking good. I like it.
Thank you.
I talk to a lot of celebrities and a lot of famous people.
Mm-hmm.
And Hux for Harlem is a nonprofit organization. What are some of the keys to success that you would pass on to some of the young people that's watching you right now?
Well, some of the important keys to success would be, to me, one is to find something that you're passionate about.
Yeah.
Because if you're passionate about something that you like doing, you love doing, then it's not work.
Yeah.
Because you want to do it. And so you will do your best at it all the time because you don't have to work hard at it. Everything you do, you love. Every part of learning, every aspect of it, you love. So find your passion and start with that. Then the next thing to do is to continue to be aware of community. It's important to make sure you take care of community because community will always take care of you
if you take care of it. That's right.
And then also there's a responsibility we have in doing that. We're responsible for keeping our communities strong and safe and vibrant, then they can give back to us, and then it continues to grow, and they don't die out. So it's important to understand community.
Yeah.
I think other parts of being successful and keys to success is understanding really hard work and understanding work ethic. It's important to work hard and have a work ethic. That means that you're going to do everything you can to do it in excellence. That means you're going to be on time, you're going to prep beforehand, you're going to know the material, you'll know what it is to do everything you need to do so that you can be the best at whatever it is you're going to do.
So
I think those are three.
I think that's important. A lot of people who's trying to get in this game, and I talk to a lot of artists who, you know, who want to be in this game, who want to be, you know what I'm saying, in the industry. The first thing I look for is, like, if they want to work with me, is they work ethic. And I think that's very important to set that. Like, work ethic is very, very important.
True.
You're trying to make in this game, you got to have good work ethics. No good work ethics, you're really not going to go far.
That's true.
So, the Pink Elephant, who did you work with on the album? Who did you work with?
Well, I got the pleasure of working with Leon Silvers, this producer, who was a part of the Silvers family, and he also worked for Solar Records, produced for the likes of
Gladys Knight.
Yeah. Gladys Knight, the Shalimar, Whispers, Blackstreet.
Blackstreet, yeah.
So he did a lot of cool stuff.
Yeah.
And, so it was cool to work with someone who already had a history of making music and even making hit songs, too. So he made songs that were not only funky, but they were hits. So it was coming from a different place that I had not worked with in that area before. So what it did was it allowed me to be able to brush up on certain skills and learn how to get beyond a certain point that might have been like a point where I was stagnant and grow past that point.
Okay.
I got to also work with some dope musicians who I work with, and they helped write music with me as well out in L.A.
Oh, all right. I'm seeing you and Jasmine Sullivan doing something. I'm not no psychic, but I'm seeing you and Jasmine Sullivan.
That's very possible. That's very possible.
Doing something, and I just got that whole vibe right now. Oh, it's beautiful. You're beautiful. Thank you for taking time to spend with me. and giving some positive words to the young people out there that's looking up to you.
Thank you so
when
much.
When does the album come out?
Pink Elephant in stores October 6th on Stax Records.
All right, all right. They got some heavy hitters. They got Angie Stone.
Yeah, they do.
Angel Lee.
Yeah.
Got a lot of Angels over
what?
There.
Well, we also have Teen Marie.
Teen Marie.
Lena James.
Wow. So we got some heavy hitters over there. That's good. That's good. She is so beautiful. She got me hypnotized, y'all. I'm hypnotized. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with Indomie, Mike Green, Hugs for Harlem. We'll be right back. Stay tuned. All right, welcome back, everybody. It's your dude, Mike Green. My girl Indomie is going to introduce the video right now.
This is Indomie on Hugs for Harlem with Mike Green and my video, Can't Hardly Wait, is up next.
I don't know why I keep
messing with you.
When you spend my money, still I keep running home.
Messing with you.
At times it's funny, but I keep running home.
Messing with you.
They tell me run, leave, but I won't. I keep on.
I keep messing with you.
I can't hardly wait to be through with you. Hardly wait. I can't hardly wait to be through with you. Hardly wait. Still I'm
messing with you.
You don't celebrate me, oh, but I keep
messing with you.
You go out but never with me. Still I keep on
messing with you.
You're always competing and I keep right on
messing with you.
And I've started resenting, but I keep right on.
I keep messing with you.
I can't hardly wait to be through with you. Hardly wait. Still I'm
messing with you.
I can't hardly wait to be through with you. Hardly wait. Still I'm
messing with you.
Now when I get up,
the only thing I'm thinking of.
When I get this monkey off of me, I bet one day I'm gonna leave. So don't tell me you love me, cause I keep right on
messing with you.
Just to please me, cause I
mess with you.
The fact remains is that I keep right on
messing with you.
And you ain't changed, but I keep right on. Hardly wait to be through with you. Hardly wait. Still I'm
messing with you.
I can't hardly wait to be through with you. Hardly wait. Still I'm
messing with you.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? We're back. It's your dude, Mike Green. And I want to ask you out there that's watching this right now to please make a contribution and donation to Hugs for Harlem. It's very important. Why? Recently, when I opened up the newspaper, there was a young man who wasn't doing anything, minding his business, and someone came and shot him. Another young person came and shot him up in Harlem. So it's very important that you support Hugs for Harlem.